Hey everybody, what's up? How you guys doing? Today I have a brand new product review for you. It's all about the L'Oreal Glossy Balms. And I know I just reviewed the L'Oreal Pop Balms. I actually found these products next to each other and they were in the permanent L'Oreal product display. So I think that these Glossy Balms are going to be permanent, but I'm not like 100% sure on that. I found these for around $7 at Walmart, a little bit over with taxes. And I have to say that I really am impressed with these as well as the Pop Balms. I like the Pop Balms for a really lightweight kind of color, but these balms, these are a lot more pigmented than the Pop ones. I would say if you want something more than just a sheer lip balm kind of thing, go for these Glossy Balms. And I'm starting off the review kind of comparing those two products because they're both new, they're both from L'Oreal, and they both kind of do the same thing, but I feel like these are more pigmented. So there are 8 of these Glossy Balms in the line, and I have 7 of them. One of them was like a really deep kind of mauve-y color and I just didn't want to try it, so I ended up getting all of the other colors. And I have to say that I do prefer some more than others, but I am going to do lip swatches. I don't have anything on my lips right now, so I'm going to get into the lip swatches first because that is the most fun part for me anyway. I love showing you guys the colors. So first up is Ginger Candy, and I'm just going to show you how it applies. It's basically like a, you know, lip crayon, just like any other drugstore jumbo lip pencil. It's the same type of packaging. I actually really like this color. It's very understated. It kind of looks like I didn't really put anything on, honestly, but I like it. And is that weird? I don't know. Tell me, what do you guys think? Is it weird to like colors that don't really look like you have anything on? Because this is totally something I would love to wear to work. I have to tell you, I'm gonna be wearing the heck out of this probably. So there is Ginger Candy, and let me do a quick hand swatch for you. And there it is. It's really creamy. And you guys saw, I mean, it kind of, you know, you can wear it sheer if you would like to, but it builds up to a really nice pigmented, you know, finish. And it does have a lot of gloss to it. You can see this is on my lips, you know, straight from the tube, no gloss on top. And it really does have that nice shine. Definitely notice that it's creamy. There's no glitter in here, which is my favorite finish in a lip product. So I'm really happy with that. This shade is called Innocent Coral and I love it. You guys know I'm all about coral lips for summer, and I feel like this is a really subtle lip. You know, it's noticeable, but it's not over the top crazy. And I feel like if you guys have never tried a coral lipstick before, this is like the perfect beginner coral lip product. Next up is My Baby Doll. This is a really pretty light pink, perfect for every day. I've been wearing this to work nonstop. I'm surprised the tip hasn't dulled down more because I love this shade so much. It's got kind of like a mauve-y tone to it. It's not like too bright. It's not too like crazy pink. It's just nice understated pink. This shade is called Lovely Mocha, and it definitely is a taupey kind of mocha shade, and I'm not the biggest fan of these kind of shades. I know that Emily Noel 83 loves this shade though, and it looks fabulous on her, but I don't know, this color kind of reminds me of like, I don't know, just not good for me. I don't know. I feel like it's a little bit too dark for my skin tone for a nude lip. I much would rather go with this one called Ginger Candy. This is more like my kind of nude. I still think this is a pretty color, but it reminds me of like 2001, like 1999, I don't know. This shade is called Vintage Rose, and it's actually quite sheer compared to the other ones. It's still a nice pigmentation, but it's not as much as I was expecting from what I see in the tube here. This is the color that you get, so just keep in mind, Vintage Rose is a little bit lighter than the others. And here's a quick hand swatch of it. Just compared to the other shades, you can see it's kind of a little bit sheer, not like super sheer, but still just compared to these other shades right here. And that was a few layers. So yeah, I don't know what's up with this one, but it's still pretty, but a little bit sheer. This is called Pink Me Up. And this one is also a little bit more sheer than I was expecting it to be. Still really like this one though, just because it is definitely brighter than the other shades in this line. I really love bright lip colors. And this is still, you know, got that comfortable moisture to it. So definitely a great pick if you want something bright. And last but not least, I have Baby Berry. This is seriously pigmented. This was one swipe on my lips, and I really like the shade because it's like a pinkish red, almost scarlet. It definitely isn't like full on red, but it's not hot, hot pink either. So I feel like this is a great like in between kind of color. And let me show you a quick hand swatch of Baby Berry, just so you can see like how pigmented it is. You can also kind of try to layer it, but I mean, it doesn't really get any more pigmented than like two swipes with these balms here. So there you go, and there are swatches of all of them. So about the formula, I really want to say that these are just balms. They're not going to leave a stain on your lips. They're not, you know, in like the Revlon balm stains or anything. It's just purely balm and gloss. It's really there to give you moisture and a nice shine. And with that being said, these do have nice moisture. I really do like the way these sit on my lips. They feel comfortable enough to the point where I would feel okay if I forgot a lip balm in my bag. I do have lots of drugstore lip pencils. I mean, I have NYX, Revlon, Jordana, Wet n Wild, CoverGirl, Neutrogena, just a few off the top of my head, and also high-end ones. But these I like because they're just a balm, you know, and they feel comfortable. They're not going to, you know, they don't feel sticky. They don't have a weird scent to them. Since they are so moisturizing though, they don't really last on my lips longer than 2 to 3 hours. And if you, you know, come in contact with anything like food, you know, it's going to come off. Bottom line, if you want something that's going to hydrate your lips and feel comfortable, you know, something really low maintenance but pigmented, definitely give these L'Oreal Glossy Balms a try. I think you guys will love them, especially right now in the summertime, because they are so lightweight and they just work, you know, they just feel comfortable and it's no fuss really. So that's it for this review. Thank you guys for requesting it, by the way. I really had fun trying these out. I think they're amazing. Honestly, one of the best balms I have tried from the drugstore. I'm loving these. So if you guys see them, check them out because they are fabulous. And as always, thank you so much for watching.